It is true that in the air there is a feeling of Christmas, and it is beginning to look like Christmas. And in fact, it is the most wonderful time of the year. That is because of the love of God. Barbara Brown Taylor puts it this way. She says, Christmas is the time when the membrane between heaven and earth is so thin you can almost see it. Tonight is the night we measure all time against, Christmas night. Our sanctuary is decorated. The lights are on to celebrate the light of the world, Jesus Christ, who was sent because of the love of God. And in many ways, Christmas is a time of anticipation. It is a time of anticipation of what God is going to do and what God is going to bring. I want to tell you the story of a man named Karl Barth. Karl Barth was born in the 1870s. He died in 1968. He was born in Germany, and he lived through both world wars. And very early, he felt the call to the ministry. He became a pastor of a church, but he had what was called, back then, liberation theology. Today we might call it prosperity theology. The idea, in his own words, is he said, God is nothing but a giant forgiving Santa Claus. That whatever we ask for, we will get. Since people are basically good, he would preach, the world is getting better and better and better. And then 1917 came along. And he saw his country plunged into a world war and began to question that. But when that was over, he realized that, yeah, people were getting over these sorts of things, and that was the last war. Then Adolf Hitler came to power and he began to question what was going on in the human race. And he became compatriots with Dietrich Bonhoeffer, trying to figure out what to do with this man who was destroying their nation. And on Christmas Day, as the Allied forces were invading Germany, a bomb hit very close to his church, blew out one wall of his church, knocked him to the ground. And he says at that moment his life was changed because he no longer saw God as a goody-two-shoes. He saw that God was both a judge and full of grace. And at the same time, God was going to judge evil, but save those that came to him. And Christmas, in his mind, became this great moment where God's love and God's grace, as well as God's judgment, was shown to the world. When he was in his 90s, after World War II, he moved to the United States and became a guest lecturer at many of the large churches. And when he was in his 90s, he was before a large group of students. And he got through what he wished to say, but he was an old man. And he was short on breath. And the MC, seeing that Dr. Barth wanted to get away and rest, said, we just have one more question. In all of your theological writings, and there is a major work by Karl Barth called Church Dogmatics, and even today, it is required in Christian conservative seminaries. I had to read it and comment on it, and it is an amazing book, and he's one of those people that I'm going to see in heaven. I'm going to ask what he meant with most of what he wrote, because it's deep. And he was a very deep theological thinker. And the MC said, if you could just give us one theological insight, one thing that will open the doors of heaven, one thing that will bring us close to God, one thing that will show us what this is all about. And he said, Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. and walked away. And 2 weeks later, he went to be with the Lord. That became one of the greatest statements out of one of the greatest thinkers. And we can add complicating things to Christmas. We can add complicating things to our Christian life. The one thing Karl Barth was famous for is he would always start his talks with, "The answer is Jesus. Now, what is your question?" He felt that everything had to come back to Jesus, and therefore everything had to come back to the starting point of Christmas time, when he had that great revelation, when God woke him up but spared his life on that Christmas day. The gospel of Jesus Christ is one of love. And when we look at the Advent season and we talk about the hope and the peace and the joy, we always end with love, because love is the foundation of what it is all about. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. 2 weeks ago, when we talked about the joy of Christmas, the Christmas verse that was used was John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." That is as much a Christmas verse as the visiting of the wise men and the visiting of the shepherds, because it gives us a foundation. If there was no Christmas, therefore, we would not know the intensity of God's love. You can wander through the Old Testament and look, and you will see God's grace and God's judgment. You will see God's wrath and God's forgiveness. But there's nothing really that gives us a strong sense of God's intense love for us. The Jews were aware that God was love, that is found in the Old Testament. But to see it, you had to be there at the first Christmas. You had to be there to see God incarnate. And as Simeon said, as he lifted Christ to the heavens, this is the consolation, the Savior of Israel. And he will cause the rising and the falling. And it is all because of the love of God. God loves us, not some of the time, not when it is convenient, but in every moment of every day. And I would dare say that every time God does something for you, near you, at you, or to you, it is because he loves you. And there can be confusion, because we don't always understand love the same way God understands love. And if God really loved me, we say, then I wouldn't be in this traffic jam, and I wouldn't, you know, have to drive in the rain, and all these things. But God's plan for you, if I can say that, God's plan for all of us is based on eternal and forever love. And there will be a day when we will stand before him, and we will be able to understand once and for all what eternal, intense, God-based love is. And then we can go find Karl Barth and sit at his feet for 2,000 or 3,000 years and listen to his stories of how he interacted with Jesus Christ. So Christmas is the celebration of the birth of love. We call his name Jesus, but he is love incarnate. He is God's plan for our salvation. And God could have, way back in the garden, wiped us out and started all over, but he decided to send his Son. The Bible says in Romans 8, "Neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." And that started on the first Christmas. There is a Peanuts comic strip in which Lucy and Linus are standing at the base of a hill. Lucy says, someday I'm going over the hill and find the answers to my dreams. Some days I'm going over that hill and find hope and fulfillment. I think for me, all the answer to life lie beyond those clouds and over the grassy slopes of that hill. Linus removes the thumb from his mouth, points toward the hill, and responds, perhaps there is another little kid on the other side of the hill who is looking this way and thinking that all the answers of life lie on this side of the hill. Lucy looks to Linus and says, "Ah, forget it, kid," and walks away. We can look for our fulfillment anywhere we want, over that hill, in that new car, in that Christmas movie, but only when we have Jesus Christ, who we know Christ and God's fulfillment. There was a youth group once that was performing the manger scene. Joseph and Mary and all the other characters were ready in their places. They did their part with seriousness and commitment, looking as pious as they possibly could. Then it came time for the shepherds to enter, dressed in flannel bathrobes and towel headgear. The shepherds proceeded to the altar steps where Mary and Joseph looked earnestly at the straw, which contained a single naked light bulb that played the part of the glowing newborn Jesus. With his back to the congregation, one of the shepherds said to the little boy playing Jesus, in a very loud whisper for all the cast to hear, "Well, Joe, when are you going to pass out those cigars?" The solemn spell of the occasion was not simply broken by his remark. It exploded. Mary and Joseph's cover was completely destroyed, as it became impossible to hold back the burst of laughter. The chief angel, standing on a chair behind them, shook so hard in laughter that she fell off her chair and took the curtain backdrop and all the rest of the props down with her. She just kept rolling on the floor, holding her stomach because she was laughing so hard. The whole set was in shambles. Amazingly, the only thing that did not go to pieces was the light bulb. It never stopped shining. Jesus Christ is the baby in the manger, and no matter how much your world is falling apart, he will never stop shining. He is the light of the world. So because of love, we have hope, and hope eternal. We have joy, and joy unspeakable. We have peace that surpasses all understanding, and because of love, we have Christmas. No love, no Christmas. And so Christmas is the living promise that no matter what, we are loved and loved and loved. No matter what, God loves you so much that he sent his only son, that through him you can have everlasting life. Christmas is a celebration of God's love. Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, I just praise you for Christmas, for you sending your son, for the fact that you loved each one of us so much that you sent your son to die on a cross. And it all started with that first Christmas. Lord, we praise you for that. We praise you that no matter what, your love continues. You do not falter. You do not change your mind. You do not wonder why you did it. You just love us and love us and love us no matter what. And Lord, we praise you for that. And we praise you for the Christmas season when we can remember this year after year. Lord, help us to keep our eyes on you as the stress and excitement of Christmas come. Help us to focus on you, the God of love, who sent his only begotten Son. Amen. And now the Cornerstone Christmas Choir, give love on Christmas Day.